So, as you might have guessed, today we're going to be talking about privacy screens. What I mean by that is creating a visual wall of plants. When you're choosing what plant to use in your yard, there are five main considerations, and we're going to go over them now. First, you want to make sure that the plant you choose is fast growing. It could be the most beautiful plant in the world, but if it's going to take over a decade before it forms into a hedge or a privacy screen, then it's the wrong plant for this situation. Next, while you want it to be fast growing, you don't want it to be too big for your situation. You don't want it to take over your life or your yard. Yes, I'm looking at you, bamboo. And then you have a lifetime of hedging and trimming and gardening and you hate yourself. So make sure that the plant is only going to get the right size for your scenario. Next, you want to make sure that that plant is evergreen. There's nothing worse than getting used to a privacy screen and then having it drop all its leaves and you're back to square one for about a third of the year. So evergreen, very important. Four and five I'm going to group together because they're basically two sides of the same coin. You want your plant to be both cold hardy and heat tolerant. So you want it to be able to survive our cold, harsh Texas winters and our cold, harsh Texas summers and continue to grow and become bigger and more beautiful year after year. Up at Covington's, we have a lot of different options that can achieve this for you. So let's go up there and check it out now. Let's grow together. We're up here at Covington's Nursery today with Nathan, and we're talking about privacy screens. I thought, what better place to start than the holly, which I think of as just a classic choice for a landscape. Nathan, can you tell me a little bit more about why a holly is a great choice for a North Texas yard?
What makes holly such great screens is they're so easy to take care of in our area. Almost all of the hollies are evergreen, which is a great benefit to the screen. They also leave very, very little mess or trash. They're great around decks, swimming pools, patios. They just have very, very little things to clean up. The other great thing about a holly is they come in so many varieties, sizes, and shapes, including leaf texture, overall height, and then how full they are to the ground. This is a classic cone-shaped holly, and you'll see it's full all the way to the ground. These are great for screening wrought iron fences and open areas. Another great way to do a holly as a screen is like what I have at my house, and that's a tree form holly. You can limit all the way up to where the 6 or 8 foot fence starts. That way it doesn't feel like the holly's swallowing up your entire yard.
The foliage only starts above the fence line.
Correct.
Yeah, what is it that my parents have at their house, Nathan?
Your parents have several beautiful Nelly R. Stevens
hollies. Okay, those are huge and that's what I wanna show you next. So come on, we're gonna go to my parents.
So we're here with my mom, Gayle Covington.
Hello.
I hardly ever get to see her.
That's not fair.
So listen, I'm going to be nervous until you just go ahead and tell the story that I know you're dying to tell, so just go get it over with.
Okay. So we moved here in 1984. We had a house built. This was a field. There was nothing here but cows back here, fields this way. The first house that was built was this monstrosity that towered over us. So Ryan took it upon himself, before I had even met the owners, while it was being framed, to go over there, introduce himself, and tell them that his mother and dad were horrified that there's going to be windows there to watch us 24/7.
So I think the word that you're looking for is thank you, Ryan. You're welcome, because you'll notice that there are no windows there anymore. So problem solved.
There you go. Okay.
Now, Covington's does not offer that service anymore.
Call me later. I can still do it.
And I have more stories. Should we tell more stories?
We're all done with stories. In fact, we're going to talk about these hollies. Earlier we went over a checklist, and so these hollies, they check all of these boxes. Obviously, if they're this big, then they are drought, heat, and cold tolerant because they've been allowed to get this big.
Yes.
They're fast growing, evergreen. I think if you were paying attention to the list from earlier, the red flag you might be seeing is that they're enormous.
Yes. Now, I do want to say that there are four of them back here.
But they're still huge.
No, they're huge. We used to have them in cone shape. We finally, once they got this big, let them go ahead and just go together,
so
mesh together.
If you don't have the space for this size holly in your yard, you're still in luck because hollies come in all different shapes and sizes. And I'm not just talking about sizes that you can buy them in existing. We're talking about they have been bred to reach various heights. In fact, we have one at the nursery that is a single trunk that I know only has foliage at the very top so that it can extend the height of your fence without taking up any bushiness in the actual yard itself.
I mean,
there's a million different types of hollies.
Well, maybe not a billion.
We could even do that to this, but I'm lazy right now and I don't want another bed, so.
That's a little bit of something I was hitting on earlier, that if you get the wrong type of privacy shrub, then you're gonna constantly be hedging it and trying to keep it the size that your yard needs.
Exactly.
Or you could buy it the appropriate size to begin with. I love that these have gone through different iterations. I remember when they were in a
cone shape,
What else do you want to say about them, Mom?
Just these hollies, for one, they berry. I love these because...
Berry, B-E-R-R-Y.
Yes. And so in the spring, waxwings, if you know your birds, they come in and they cover, these yellow birds cover this, and it's beautiful.
Hold on. Okay, I was going to say, this makes it sound like a terrible thing, birds all over your yard, but you're saying it's a beautiful thing.
Oh.
I don't know. I guess it could go either way.
Okay, for me it's beautiful.
Okay,
because they come and go.
So
within...
I have like grackles or something that come
and live in my bamboo. No,
again.
Within 2 hours they have covered this, taken the berries, and they're gone.
And it's like a fun Christmassy thing for you.
I'm not going to say it's springtime.
Oh, springtime. Oh. Well, I thought I get berries and Christmas. So I don't know. Apparently, I've never noticed these berries or the birds.
Okay. The other thing I want to say about this is the fact that just because it's here in this corner and it doesn't cover the house, my neighbors, who I love, they like to have their coffee right on their patio. Their patio is higher than the fence.
It is. They're kind of looking down.
So this not only helps me to have privacy, but it helps them that I don't look like the scary woman that's always over here listening. So.
Even though she is.
No, I'm not.
Okay, Mom, before we leave, tell me, what kind are we looking at here?
This is a Nelly Stevens Holly. And this is as big as this is going to get. This
good.
This
That's
is
what I was
full grown.
Ask.
Full
okay.
grown.
So it's not just going to continue like a marshmallow man expanding. This is as big as it gets.
This
and do
it.
You think that it will continue to? It's not going to grow, but it'll live for many, many years.
Longer than I will. It's okay. It's all right.
Well, on that note,
we're done.
So we're switching gears. We have plants with a completely different look, but that still make great options for privacy screens. We're talking about junipers, cedars, and cypress. Nathan, tell us about these.
You know, one of the great things about these guys is when a customer comes in and asks us for a drought-tolerant screen, this is the first one we take them to. And we all know with our hot Texas summers that drought-tolerant is important. The other great thing about the junipers and cedars is they're very, very clean, just like the hollies, no mess,
great.
Which is important to a lot of people. And they come in a multitude of colors, leaf textures, and shapes.
You talked about drought. How are they with the cold?
They do great with the cold. Most of them are cold hardy anywhere from 0 to -10.
So they're great with our drought and our cold. I'm thinking, because didn't you tell me that a lot of these are native to this area?
That's right, Ryan. The Eastern Red Cedar,
that one
is native to right here in our area. And it's an awesome plant to grow for a screen.
You know, I have the perfect yard in mind that has both junipers in the landscape, and it's close by to some native growing cedars. So let's go and check that out. Okay, so I wanted to show you these guys. This is the Spartan juniper. They're dramatic, they're stately, they have that iconic pyramidal shape, and as you can see, he's just planted them all in a row to separate this outer yard from his inner courtyard. Great choice here, the Spartan juniper. In the same family as juniper is this guy. It's an Eastern Red Cedar. Not only is it native to Texas, it's native to Northeast Texas. Anyone that lives around here is going to recognize this plant. You'll see them growing dozens, maybe hundreds of them, just wild in fields. They are a great privacy plant, but as you might notice, they get big. If you have the room for it, though, it could be the perfect plant for a perfect situation. And this guy has it. He has his house over here, and he wants to separate it with a wall of plants. All of this that's happening over here, this guy's gonna get huge, it's gonna live forever, and it's gonna survive our harsh Texas winters and our harsh Texas summers. So I'm starting to get the impression that this homeowner loves junipers, because also in the same family are these Arizona cypress. They're the same as the Eastern Red Cedar, but they have, as you can see, more of a silvery gray color. But that's not even the most impressive thing about them. Without these bushes, this homeowner and all of his neighbors would basically be able to see each other all the time. You can see that these have formed a wonderful privacy fence of gorgeous foliage that'll just keep getting bigger and more luscious as time goes on. One last thing before you decide that a juniper is right for you, don't forget, they get enormous. So just make sure that you have the space for it before you go and plant it in your yard. So Our last stop is a plant I'm sure everyone in the South recognizes. It's the classic magnolia tree. It has that iconic white bloom you can see here. Nathan, take it away. Tell me about the magnolia.
You know, one of the first questions I get from customers concerning magnolias is, are they hard to grow here? And the answer is absolutely not. Magnolias love our clay soil, and they love the heat and the cold that we get here in North Texas. The other thing I love in magnolias, if you have a small space to screen, you can use a dwarf magnolia that'll get 15 or 20 feet tall and about 10 feet wide. Or if you have a large space to screen, you can get a D.D. Blanchard magnolia that'll get 40 feet tall and 40 feet wide.
Okay, so the D.D. Blanchard, I think that those are the ones in the customer's yard that I want to show y'all next. He has planted them all in a row, and you cannot even see that he has a neighbor at all. It's fantastic. Let's go check that out. So most people in Texas are going to be very familiar with the magnolia. They put on those big, white, fragrant blooms in the summer. But while they can be a single standalone tree, like a statement piece in your yard, you can also line them up as a hedge. This is just magnolia after magnolia, creating a screen of privacy so that these two neighbors don't have to be on top of each other. So today we talked about many options for privacy and creating privacy screens, but that is just the tip of the iceberg. Come up to Covington's Nursery and we can talk about your size and height requirements and figure out which is the best suit for you. Well, that's all I got for today. Eric, you think you can give me some privacy here? Oh, let's grow together.
Hello, my name is Ryan Covington. My family owns a nursery, Covington's Nursery. I didn't actually get into gardening, though, until much later in life, until I got a house with a yard. I guess you could call me a late bloomer. Who's writing this? I'm not saying that. No, because actually I was an early bloomer. I'd rather tell the story of how my parents, every time I got in trouble at school, would put me on the landscape crew. Yeah, when I was like 10 or 3. I mean, I was young. I was very young. When you get expelled from school, is the punishment. There's no need to punish the punishment. They had already taken care of the punishment.
Did you do anything wrong? I probably did. I can't even remember what it was. I think I unstapled the pages about evolution.
It doesn't matter. What I'm saying is that I did something wrong, and they punished it with expelling.
Punished me for getting expelled because the expelling was the punishment.
You don't punish a punishment.